They illegally arrested Julian Assange today. It is absolutely shocking. There's so much I just can't even see straight. Now, when they jailed Chelsea, who was pardoned by Obama, it was just a way to recharge Chelsea under a new charge for not rolling over on Julian, and she had already given exact testimony of how she gave the documents to WikiLeaks, who's a publisher. And what they're saying now is that he's charged with conspiring with Chelsea Manning in 2010. No, Julian didn't conspire. He wasn't even in the service or the United States. He just published what Chelsea, then Bradley Manning, was giving. So I'm going to scroll down here, and then I want to see this one where it says unlikely to face U.S. charges over publishing classified material. So what it says here on WikiLeaks, just let me get to it. I've been scrolling over dozens of links and articles. He's arrested in relation to a U.S. extradition request for conspiracy with Chelsea for publishing Iraq war logs, Cablegate, Afghan war logs, and precisely the persecution for which he was granted asylum under the 1951 Refugee Convention in 2012. And this picture shows them taking him. And can you imagine, like, look at this nightmare. The thing is, he hasn't been out in the sun. This is just inhumane. Look at them dragging him. Poor thing. And I mean, when you've been alone for a year and no one's been allowed to talk to you and you haven't had any freedom whatsoever, and they've revoked the asylum, everybody, which was a fake revoke. You know, they had no grounds to revoke it. They just are cheating, lying, stealing every crime that you can commit in order to not let him be free and to keep Chelsea in jail. And what they said about Chelsea was that since she wouldn't testify against Julian and against the government, that what they were going to do was leave her in jail until they got Julian. So in real terms, Chelsea should already be out today and isn't. And there's just all kinds of talk. So it says, Metropolitan Police confirm Assange has been arrested in relation to a U.S. warrant. Assange lawyers confirms it concerns a conspiracy with Chelsea Manning in relation to 2010 publications. So it's what started under Obama, and they just never dropped it. And it's absolutely frightening to see what they're capable of and what they've done here. So then there's just, you know, of course, it's the highest tweets on Twitter. And it says on here, we cannot allow the sociopaths or psychopaths who run the world to imprison Julian for life for publishing the truth about the corrupt, brutal, and illegal behavior. And we cannot allow them to keep Chelsea Manning imprisoned indefinitely for providing the truth to Julian. So again, this is just sick governments at work. And I want to see what, because they're accusing him of conspiring with Chelsea. You know, there's no conspiracy. When you go to any kind of a press to tell what you know, Chelsea's the one that committed the crime, because you have to keep war and service material, quote, private and classified and secret. But that's how they got away with the brutal act of war and killing innocent people and getting away with it. And what they want to do is repunish Chelsea, who was pardoned, and, you know, because she wouldn't testify, but they can't make you retestify and try and get you in a perjury trap to charge you again. So it's just absolutely shocking. And it says she still continues to sit in jail, but the judge's order in that was that she would only be held in there for refusing to testify until they arrested Julian. So now that Julian's arrested, again, she should absolutely be free. So it's, everyone's just in shock. Also, WikiLeaks posted this today where it said U.S. routinely spied on Brazil. What didn't they do? The thing about, they just don't want WikiLeaks to publish in general, and they don't want any freedom for anyone to publish this amount of truth about how sick and dirty the deep state is. And I haven't had a chance to look at this article, but here's what it says: unlikely to face U.S. charges over publishing classified documents. And the one thing Lenin Moreno stated was that he's not going to allow. Oh, this is the one I can't read unless I join it. All right, well, that's the wrong thing. I don't know what that then says. But Lenin Moreno was saying that he wouldn't put him into any country where they face the death penalty. And you can't face the death penalty for being a publisher. And so they're lying all over fake news. They're lying all over the map and trying to charge him with a 1917 law, which doesn't apply, but that was the best they could get in the Constitution. And let me just see what Reuters says, because that's top news. And, you know, breaking news. Conspiracy to commit computer intrusion. That is just a fake, ridiculous charge. This is what fascism looks like, looks away from journalists for publishing. And again, they're trying to call him a criminal instead of a publisher. And the problem is that this is a farce. Assange has done the same thing as journalists have done, taken information from other sources and published them. What they're saying is, what's the saying? Don't shoot the messenger. So, you know, there's going to be so much backlash from logical, smart, and truthful people. And I pray now that this is done, that something happens within Trump, because I think Trump was going to be set up, that if he tried to prevent this, they were going to derail him from everything, because they're looking for anything they can do to target him. And they've put him in a box between, you know, now making him the enemy if he does anything to get involved in this and try to pardon him. And so it's really a nightmare. And I think this is the deep state so desperate, because all of them are going to end up in trouble for what they've done. And William Barr just stated yesterday that things are coming down for them. So they certainly don't want Julian out, because there's more crimes that weren't reported. And so what they want to do is send a message to anybody not to publish anything more about the deep state than we have already. And with James Comey, Clapper, Rod Rosenstein, Susan Rice, Hillary, Obama, everybody in that little motley crew, every single one of them is running petrified. So they don't want, as the charges come down from what they did with the FISA and all that, anything else to be able to be published. So this is also a warning to anybody that was even going to intend to publish more on the crimes of these people, that if they do, they're going to be falsely charged and silenced and their lives taken away. And the timing of this is very suspect, because yesterday William Barr said yes, these people spied on Trump. And if you think WikiLeaks didn't have more release and prove on that, you're wrong. And that's why they probably just published that thing today saying that USA spied on Brazil, because there's just so much that they have done, and it would all be contained inside even things they haven't relayed, they haven't released yet. So I think that the fact that they did it today is because of what William Barr said yesterday. But what you have now are two innocent people being charged falsely, silenced, and then the deep state in a panic. But here's the thing that's already true. There's enough already released from all the crimes of these predators, and it's been on Sean Hannity day after day after day, the lying to a FISA judge, the fake dossier, all of that stuff, and all, Hillary's deleted emails, and they released classified things. So the thing that's going to happen is that they're going to get found guilty anyway. But I think what they did with this move was try to make sure that nothing else gets published, because they are retaliatory. They don't want anything else to come out, even though there is probably so much more we don't even know how to believe it. And then if they silence Julian and lock him up and call him a traitor, call him a whatever, they're going to end up making people afraid to tell what else they know. But I still think this is going to backfire on everybody, because when the dust settles, the majority of people are going to put out the truth even more, and people aren't going to look well to this. And there's already people saying there's no difference between the Trump administration and the Obama administration in all these tweets. And this is true. And this is what I said to people. But they're definitely trying to choke President Trump and make it, they're trying to make him a criminal in a way, which isn't true. It's all fake news. But they're trying to charge Julian and call Julian the enemy. And so that if President Trump pardons or supports him, they're going to try to use that to derail him for 2020. And so they're making up all these things about Julian, so that they can make Julian look like he's a spy and he's the enemy when he's a publisher. And then if Trump even goes near trying to forgive him and pardon him and use the Constitution in relation to him, then he will be supporting a criminal, which is false. But that's what also I think they're going to use to try to take Trump out of 2020. Now, initially, everyone was expecting Trump to free Julian and to get involved. But the deep state, because they can't do Russian collusion and there wasn't any, they don't have anything left to make Trump the enemy about, because they made asses of themselves and they were idiots. So the next other thing that they can do to push for 2020 is not let Trump get reelected if he pardons Julian. And it's going to be an intense, intense battle. Now, here's what I can predict. Just say they're going to leave him, according to what I found out so far, they're going to give him a mandatory year sentence over in UK for skipping a bail hearing, which is ridiculous because he had asylum at the time. And the charges for which he was skipping the bail were the fake charges that Sweden was lying, saying he had raped somebody, and this is what the deep state always does, and those charges have been dropped. So when you have asylum, you don't leave asylum to go face a bail hearing, because the asylum is protecting you so that you, when you're being persecuted, you don't go get set up so that your asylum doesn't work. So what the only way to cheat and steal him was to revoke the asylum and lie about why they're revoking it, so that they look innocent and they don't look like they cheated anyone else out of asylum. And that's also a lie. And all of this just shows you how sick all the connected countries are and how afraid they are of any person that's going to publish this much truth. And all the journalists that we see in fake news are little mockingbirds, and they won't even report any stories that are true, including what's happening in illegal immigration. And by the way, just a sidebar from this for a second, everyone should watch the video that Glenn Beck did explaining why they're overloading immigration and bringing in all these migrants. It's fascinating what he uncovered, and I haven't even been able to cover that because we've been on this since last weekend. And I couldn't figure out if they were going to take him before or after Moreno comes in to meet Trump in the United States in a few days. And I had suspected that they were going to do it before because they switched the hearing into total Spanish instead of English, which was something really strange that they've decided to do. And I've been trying to research why are they doing that. But all this stuff, everybody, they're silencing everybody and not letting people talk. So it takes hours to find out any of this. And of course, if anyone has the Washington Post, this article is saying he's unlikely to face charges in the U.S. Now, they shouldn't, you know, if they just arrest him and they serve him for a year, it's going to be, make him serve a year, it's going to be where do they put him after that? Because unless they extradite him, then they can't do anything with these other charges. Just because you charge someone in the U.S. with this big fake law, it doesn't mean they're actually going to bring him over here, but they could. And they're more likely to do that, which would be why they revoked asylum. And they also had to revoke asylum to get him out of the embassy, because under the embassy and under asylum, he would be protected to stay there. So this is just total sick, evil, evil deep state. It hasn't changed under anybody. And it's a violation of law and order, and you have all the wrong people praising this, saying that no one's above the law, except that they're abandoning the law in order to get him, and you have the weakest of people lying about that, trying to spread that through fake news. And fake news is only going to be reporting now the lie and not the truth. The only place you're going to find the truth is on social media. So everybody, it's a shocking, shocking thing that they did. It's sick and evil and false, and people were awake. So the fight now is going to be to free both Julian, to free Chelsea, and to stop the false charges and pray they don't extradite him. But at least for now, according to what has happened, they're taking him into the UK for jail, for skipping bail, leaving him locked up, and then they've revoked his asylum in order to get him out of the embassy. And I will update this when I have more. Thank you.